Hello and welcome. My name is Robert Beevers. I'm a Zoom Room specialist, normally based in New York, as you can tell from my accent, but I'm here in our San Jose office to take you all through an art of the possible with Zoom Rooms. A couple of things to note. This is not really an executive briefing center per se. This is just half of a floor that we managed to cobble together and show like all our really cool stuff. And also, this is an open session, so please feel free to ask questions in the chat, throw it in there, and my Zoom colleagues on the call will ask me live as we kind of go through. Other thing worth noting as well is that everything I'm going to show you today is live and available. We're not selling vaporware here today. So you're going to see a lot of our really, really interesting things. So what we're finding from our customer base is this, we're struggling with this idea of like, how do I manage the workforce in this new way? And 75% of our customers surveyed are saying that they're going to be permanently hybrid from this point forward when they do trickle back to the office. And interestingly, 94% of those individuals surveyed are saying that they're going to be coming to the office between one and three days a week. And their primary concern is safety. And so we're going to talk about how environmental features within Zoom Rooms become really, really important. And that starts right here at the beginning.
If you don't mind, I would just like to introduce Mohammed Khan from CDW. He had a couple words he wanted to share about the partnership with Zoom for our customers in Canada, and he'll kick it back to you to run this incredible tour. So thank you very much. Mohammed, did you want to jump in?
Yeah, hi everyone. This is Mohammed Khan here, the solution architect. Collaboration with CW. I'm a CW badged employee with CCNA in collaboration and CCNA network and switching. So I can help with any questions regarding any collaboration tools and licenses and anything surrounding, like anything with the surrounding hardware manufacturing from like a Zoom room standpoint of view and other licenses. So if you have any questions, you can get in touch with our CW account managers teams who are like trained and your trusted advisor. And they are backed with strong expertise of people like me and my team. So we can help you with all your digital needs. So thanks. I'm very excited to be on this virtual tour with you guys and Zoom. So let me pass it on to Robert Beaver. Thanks, Robert.
You're welcome, and thank you. So the first thing that we're gonna be greeted with as we come into office is what we call the Zoom kiosk. And so as we zoom in on the kiosk, I've got a couple of things that are worth noting. A, this is the only area in the Zoom portfolio that I can customize, so I can change the background, change the text, and so on and so forth. You can see two buttons, one called receptionist, two workspaces. So let's start with the receptionist because we want to get in today. And again, we have a sub menu, which is completely configurable by you, receptionist, facilities, security, and so on and so forth, deliveries, whatever it might be. And each one of these has a call queue behind it. So up to four people can answer these calls as we kind of go forward. And so and that allows you to have a follow the sun model. So starting in Toronto, finishing in Vancouver. And so it really is an interesting way of being able to do that. So once our receptionist has answered the call and let us in, we can then find where we're going to work today. So I think we've got Faza. Oh, hello, my friend. Can you let the CDW team and customers in?
Absolutely. You're all set.
Awesome. Thank you, sir. All righty. Catch you later. So what we're going to do, is, just because it's a little easier to do it on a bigger screen over here, that was a D10 a 27-inch touchscreen, very inexpensive. Forgive me, I'm going to quote in US dollars because, as you can tell, I am an American, and they retail at around $600-$700 US. This is actually a touchscreen from D10 as well. This is the D10 D7 in 55-inch guys, retailing at around $4,500, but it could be any touch-enabled LG, whomever you want device. And so I'm going to hit the workspaces. This is then going to pull up my interactive map of my office here today, my floor. And I can see all the rooms that are available, not available for the day. And I can zoom in on them. Can I come here? And I can do an unlimited amount of room reservations. So for instance, this is our EBC wellness room. No video in there because it's a wellness room. We also have prenatal rooms and so on and so forth. But it's important that I book it and make that available. And so what I'm going to do is just kind of book my hot desk for the day. So I'm going to check in, and it's going to ask me to scan my QR code, which I'm going to do, scan my QR code, and I'm going to reserve my space for the day. And it really is as simple as that. All I did is reserve that. Now, I could have done it ahead of time on my laptop. I could have done it ahead of time on my mobile device, but you know, I'm disorganized, and so I didn't get it done ahead of time. Now, outside of our Zoom room, so I booked a space, but I could have also booked a meeting room. R is our meeting room scheduler, and I'm with people who also pronounce scheduler correctly, so I'm very glad to be here. We are using a NeatPad. This is a fit-for-purpose device that allows me to be able to book the room and so on and so forth, but it has some other interesting features that we particularly like. For instance, you can see the LED lights on the outside, and as we scan down the hallway, you get a bit of a glimpse of why the LED lights on the side are so interesting, because at a glance, you get to be able to see which rooms are in or out of a meeting. So really, really straightforward. Now, as you can see, this is reserved, but if I hit in the reserve, it will tell me all the meetings that are in use today. But if I want to, I can just hit the reserve another room, and that brings up that same interactive map that I was showing you earlier. And so the map is available here, it's available on the scheduling devices, and it's obviously available on the kiosk as well. And I can roll out an unlimited amount of these scheduling devices. And again, this retails at around $650 US. It's power over Ethernet, very good. And the other thing I would note as we come into this room, this is a NeatPad, which is what we use on the outside of our rooms. But this is actually a Logi room. And so it doesn't have to, you know, we can sort of like change it around, you know, accordingly. So this is our largest conference room here on our second floor. It's about 35 feet long by 13 feet wide. And this was a pro AV space before we took over. Eric Guan, our CEO, would sit in here, and there was tens of thousands of dollars worth of equipment. Ceiling mics, mics here in a table, and we have ripped all of that out. We ripped out the DSPs and the racks of equipment. And what have we replaced it with? We've replaced it with this Logi Rally Bar for around $3,500. We've gone from $30,000 worth of equipment down to about $3,500. And just to show you how simple it is, we have this very cool bracketing system here. And as I pull it apart, you can see power, Ethernet, and obviously the HDMI cables, you know, and that's it. And so we're all about simplicity in these rooms and like making sure that it's a kind of like a high quality experience at the same time. So I'm going to come to the head of the table. And I'm going to join you in this meeting. Now, this is the Logi tap, which has the Zoom control interface, so very, very easy to use. But actually, what we're starting to see is people are saying, do I want to use a high traffic area? And so probably not. And so I do have the ability to be able to pair these rooms with our phones here very, very simply. And I'm just going to hit start and join.
Recording in progress.
Unmute. So now I've gone from a lapel mic to a room mic, and it's a lot more echoey in here. But a couple of things that are worth noting. I'm just going to zoom in to show you quite how far away I am, but also how high quality these cameras are. And so this is the Logi Rally Bar that uses a really, really good optical zoom. And again, I'm talking at my normal level. I'm not having to raise my voice. And the only mic, and it's actually erroneous to call it a mic because it's a many mics, it's a mic array in the bar, are at the front of the room. And I can add additional mics. If this room was any larger, I probably would. And it's a very, very easy way of doing it. With Logi, they allow you to add another additional three. Very, very simple. And I put auto framing on. So as my colleague comes and join me here, the system automatically readjusts. And we're into the we're in it together. You know, this is a hands-free experience. I'm not having to hit presets. So a simple kind of high-quality experience managing into these traditional rooms. So I'm going to hang up here now, and let's move to a smaller huddle room space.
So. When I started in video in the late 90s, I started when I was 2 years old, the huddle room was the biggest innovation in video. And all a huddle room is a small meeting room. So I'm always a bit sort of like, isn't it just a small meeting room? But in this room, we've even simplified it even further. So this is a D10D7, similar to the device you saw at the front. And what's really good about this is here's my schedule for the day. But I can use this as a local collaboration device. I don't have to be in a meeting if I don't want to. So I can quickly sort of join the, join it. I like putting it into different modes, like the Blackboard mode and so on and so forth, so it's easier to see. And so I then can use this and sort of hit send, and send it over via Zoom chat or via Zoom email. I won't do that. And so, really, really easy way of being able to use it. And the other thing that people, I think, don't really realize is that Zoom, we're a huge phone provider as well. So this is a giant phone if I want it to be. And so I can just quickly call myself and hit go. And so I can use this as a phone because Zoom Phone and Zoom Rooms reside on the same platform. And there's the call coming in. I won't answer it for obvious reasons. So really, really nice way of being able to, take part. Now, I am, as a New Yorker, very touch phobic. I just don't want to touch things if I don't have to. Well, why not use my voice? So let's try that. Hello, Zoom. Join meeting.
Do you want to join the meeting?
Yes.
So now I've joined the meeting from the unit itself, and I got to use my voice. And in fact, this ability to be able to use our voices is something that grew rapidly in the pandemic times for us working from home. So as I'm at home and I'm thinking about coming back into the office, I want similar technology available for me. But I can do more than just enter a call. I can do things like, hey, bring so-and-so in, bring Lindsay in, or I can say, hey, I'm not going to say the word because it prompts it. Hey, start the recording. And in fact, we will be supporting up to 23 languages this year, starting with French, Spanish, and then German. And so, hey, Zoom, will you, translate this into French? And then that will have a French transcription along the bottom. And so the features for this are really, really interesting, sort of like a really, really straightforward way of being able to do things. And again, we have this as a sort of like a bit of a prop. Frankly, it seems like nonsense. You don't need an HDMI cable anymore. I can just share from my device. I don't need to be able to do that. So I simply share my screen and then whatever it is that I want to share. Sorry, one second. Let's see. And so I just compare using the ultrasound, and I can just share away whatever it is. Maybe I'm just sharing my desktop right now, but I think you kind of get the idea. And so really, really easy to share. And I can do that. It's ultrasonic, so I can do that from anything that has a speaker. So any mobile phone, laptop, iPad, really, really straightforward. And then while I'm here to tell you all off, if you come into meeting rooms and you join the meeting at the same time from your laptop, it's a terrible video experience. Don't do that. Instead, join via companion mode like I just did, that allows you to be able to control the meeting, allows you to be able to share your content and even view the content, but you're not then causing confusion by joining it and mics being on and so on and so forth. So forgive me for telling you off, but I know you all do it. Right, so the huddle room experience is done. And again, to mention the price, this is around $4,500 for this unit. This is 55 inch. They also do a 75 inch, which is more expensive correspondingly. Okay, I'm gonna hang up here, go back to the mic, and we're gonna go into the open space.
All righty, welcome back. I affectionately call this area our millennial area because it has soft furnishing. And so in this area, we've got a couple of units here. This is a Poly X50 bar, and it's in a kind of configuration on a cart. And then next to it is a neat bar in a very similar configuration. Now, I'm going to ask the question rhetorically, what is the problem with video in open spaces? Well, people talking, invariably loud Englishmen on their phones, walking around, talking about their share portfolio. So what I'm going to do is, again, switch from the camera to the system and join you here.
Okay. How do you know that you're not a millennial? When you sit down, you make that noise. There we go. So here's the problem.
I'm talking away, but there's lots of people in this office. It's a busy place. So what we have in working here is an acoustic fence. So this will age some of you. So imagine a cone of silence emanating from the very middle of the unit. And then I can set a configurable space. We set ours to be just around this sofa here. So as I continuously talk and walk out of range, it will automatically come back into range. It completely cuts the sound off. So I can configure the width and the depth of this. And the applications aren't just for open spaces like this. The applications are also for these walls are paper thin. I've never seen an office be constructed well ever in a modern era. And so sound bleeds through, and the ability for you to not have to remunerate the room, instead turn this technology on, is really, really important. As I said to you earlier, I'm a native New Yorker, and sirens are, I don't hear them anymore, but you, the remote participants, you hear them all the time. And so with this technology, all the sirens are drowned out. And so it's removing 90% of that top end sound, so top end sound, you know, stuff like that, in conjunction with Zoom's ability to be able to remove repetitive sound, so the air conditioning noises and so on and so forth. It really makes it for a much sort of like more optimal video experience. Because again, we've all been used to working from home and having a high quality experience, other than when the kids break in. And so this, you know, you want to be able to give them a high quality experience as they come into the open area. While we're in an open area, let's also talk about digital signage real quick. So I'm going to
Digital signage is something that is remarkably included in the Zoom room price, and a lot of people don't realize that. If I have one Zoom room license, I can roll out unlimited digital signage. All I need to do that is a screen and a form of compute. This is running a Zule stick, which retails at around $250. It can be any. In fact, some of our manufacturers are coming out with digital signage dedicated compute. Logi and also Yealink are bringing those out imminently. And so, and I can run on here local interesting content. And that content could also be the map I showed you earlier. That can also be local environmental data, like how many people are in today and so on and so forth. And so really, really easy. And then the other thing that I can do is I can use this as a broadcast device as well. And so if you're doing a CEO address or a town hall, I don't want to have to huddle into a small room or have everybody at their desks sort of joining via their laptops. I want to have a sort of community feel, but I don't want to be in a small room where I feel like I'm breathing on people. And so to be able to put the content, to put the call up here and have it as a one-way broadcast device is really, really a nice way of sort of being able to sort of collaborate as well. So again, and then the other thing I would say as well, and as we pan over here, I don't have to have a dedicated screen like that. I could actually also use the dormant Zoom room units as a digital signage thing. So we have here a playlist playing on here. But again, it could be welcome to room two. How about using your voice? You know, little tips on how to use it and so on.
Hey, Robert.
All right.
Yes. I have a question that popped up in the chat here. So the acoustic fence is coming from the poly unit and it's supported by Zoom, correct? So if didn't recognize the hardware capability, we would not have it. So they work hand in hand.
Work hand in hand, and in fact, Neat, which is behind me, the Neat bar, they also now support it. They call it acoustic bubble. And so it's both, you know, the question often is, where does the Zoom software end and the poly begin? Well, it's kind of like it's both. And so, yeah, it's a poly feature. Poly have, without a shadow of a doubt, a massive lead on audio capability. As you all know, poly have been around a long time with phones and so on and so forth. But yeah, it's an in conjunction thing. We work together on it. And in fact, you know, things we're working on to take it even further are the idea of like, why pick up sound all the way around here at all? The only sound is emanating from my mouth, as my teachers and mother used to say. So to have a mic that only picks up sound from my mouth becomes sort of like a really, really interesting thing. Okay, so if you recall at the beginning of the demo, I used the interactive map and I checked in. And so now this unit is on my hot desk for the day. This is another poly unit, really, really high quality. And so I'm going to get a call onto this device here. And so, in fact, is that right? Franklin, are you guys calling me? Yeah, okay, cool. So I'm going to get a recall on this device here, and I'm going to accept it as a, you know, as an audio call. One of the things I mentioned earlier is that Zoom allows you, Zoom phone and Zoom rooms exist on the same platform. It isn't a sort of separate thing, as it were. And so therefore, if I wanted to, I could very, very easily, you know, join a meeting, add a meeting, but also I can move the meeting. Let's say I'm in this open area and I don't particularly want to stay out here. I want to have a private conversation. I can very, very simply hand this over to another room. So here comes my call. I'm receiving it on my phone and on here, but I'm actually going to accept it here. Hello. Okay. It turns out that it's my boss, and I'm probably got to talk about some of the things I said on the last tour. So what I'm going to do is transfer it. I know that the Muir Woods call behind me is available, so I'm going to go to the Muir Woods room. So Muir Woods. And so now I'm going to come over to the Muir Woods room, and the call is coming in. So turn the lights on. So here comes the call. But this, much like our kiosk, is a Zoom video enabled unit. So I'm just going to escalate it to video. But think about what I just did. I took a call. I could have chosen to answer it on my cell phone or on this device. I transferred it over to another device really, really quickly, and I escalated it to the video without ending the call. And so that is a really, really kind of, and now I'm in video. I've got the ability to be able to do all the things that, you know, such as content share and so on and so forth. So, yo, buddy, thank you. Am I getting fired for what I said earlier? Yeah, I am. I thought so. So really, really easy way of doing things. I love that kind of ability, because as we now shift back into this hybrid way of working, dedicated spaces are a rare commodity. And so for me to be able to kind of come in, work from somewhere, but also have somewhere private to be able to take calls, becomes really, really important too. I just want to make sure, because sometimes when I'm in and out, I don't necessarily hear the questions. I want to make sure that I'm not missing anything. So Zoom team on the call, or any questions that I haven't picked up?
No questions so far, just the one question. So if just everybody on the call, if you have questions, feel free to jump in. Robert's an expert and loves to answer the most difficult and complex questions you can think of.
Challenge me. So we are in our edumacation space. And so a couple of things I want to note. So, you know, in my Townberg days, you know, education spaces were a gold mine for us. There was so much equipment needed in order to make an education space work, from ceiling mics to pressure pads to multiple cameras and so on and so forth. And essentially all of that has gone. Note that this space is at a 45 degree angle, and you'll see why in a second. So just to give you some dimensions, this is 45 feet by 55 feet wide, and that will become pertinent sort of in a second. And in here, we are using a neat board. And so the neat board is an all-in-one 65-inch touchscreen. And again, so using the sort of same technology. And I'm going to join you from here. Hello, Zoom. Join meeting.
Do you want to join the meeting?
Yes.
Starting the meeting.
Okay, so now I am in the meeting, and I'm actually going to turn on the same technology. I want it to track me from the Zoom unit. And the reason for the angle is that I can then, you can see the classroom, but if I move over to my lectern where I do my edumacating, go from there. So I saw that question. Was Robert logged into the neat board? No, but the neat board did have this meeting in its calendar. So it then said, do you want to join the meeting? And it asked me which meeting I wanted, wanted to join the CDW meeting. And I was like, yes. So I don't have to be logged in. And that's, in fact, the really unique thing about Zoom Rooms is that you don't want to have an individual log into it, because this is a resource available for many, many people. But a great question. What I am going to do is I'm just going to walk to the back of the room and just demonstrate, like, as I walk towards the back, I'm going to continuously talk. I am now 45 feet away from you. There are no additional mics in this room. And so what's really happened in the last 2 years is mic technology has sort of changed radically. And so the fact that I can sort of pick this up, and we've done nothing to this room, normal corporate carpeting, really, really straightforward. So nothing kind of like particularly special here. And I can add things like a document camera really easy. I can add a secondary camera, as you can see there, really, really easily. And so if I do want to make it. Now, I want to be clear, I'm not against pro AV spaces. In fact, if this was a divisible space, so a 3-to-1 kind of auditorium, you need pro AV. You need to have more than just this. And we will work that. We in fact have a professional services organization
that works with CDW in order to be able to help you design and implement more complicated spaces. So we do understand that. But what we're seeing within Zoom Rooms, and we ship about 50,000 units a quarter globally, is that over 50% are these boards and bars, so integrated devices. So that's the compute, the video, the audio, and of course, the camera. So I'm going to hang up here, and we're going to go and show something really cool with called Smart Gallery. So bear with me.
We've talked about the idea of us in a flexible workspace, and the problem that we have in a flexible workspace is that we're all used to the Zoom gallery view, and then you come into your office, and there's your grandfather's video conferencing system, and it just doesn't jive anymore. It doesn't work. And in fact, the feature I'm just about to show you, Smart Gallery, came about from customer feedback. One of the CEOs of a large financial services organization said, "Hey, when I connect through to my Singapore office, it feels like there are ants on a table." So again, in this room, really, really simple, two existing 65-inch monitors, and we've thrown on a Neat bar. Neat bars retail at around $2,900 US, and so very, very, very inexpensive rule. So again, I am going to hang up my mic here and connect from this room.
All right. Now, could everybody do me a favor? Top right-hand corner, can you go and change the view from speaker view, if that's what you have on now, to gallery view? And if you do that, you're going to get a much better experience of what I'm just about to show you. And so, so here is the problem. I have now joined the call from my office here, and I have, there's four of us now. Mona, I've got Adley, I've got Eric, and of course myself. And all of a sudden, because we're all in a meeting together, we're so much smaller. In fact, I can see my own view, and like my head is absolutely tiny. But if I look at Eric Ross, he's about right. I want to look like Eric, right? So what I'm going to do is turn on Smart Gallery. And so what that then does is it reframes it, and then takes us, each individual, and then sends that individual out into the gallery. Now, at the moment, in our first revision of software, there are three streams. So that'll be the room. And then Atlee, you're sharing with Mona, and I'm sharing with Eric. And it's really, really cool. So in fact, if I stand up and walk over here, it recognizes me. And this is all one camera. Atlee's gonna kind of move over there, and it still, it recognizes me. And so it's a really, really straightforward, really, really cool way of being able to sort of send this back into. And now, Atlee's heard this 1,000 times, so he's bored. And so he's now gonna leave the meeting. It recognizes that he is gone and releases it. Now, remember when we talked about the mic technology, acoustic fencing, like setting a parameter of sound to be picked up? Well, we've also set a parameter of vision too. So you can see that he's hovering outside this window, but Smart Gallery is not picking him up because we don't want it to distract the meeting and picking up people as they walk by. In fact, we've even set it with a depth. So if I stand up and come to the very back, it's going to recognize that I am now out of bounds. And so think about it. I could have a table here for catering for working lunches. It's a really, really easy way of being up to date. And I'm doing all this without touching a button. It's just a really, really straightforward way of being able to sort of like do it. And so we've got more to come with Smart Gallery. This is, our first revision. We're going to increase the streams. We're going to add something called Intelligent Director. An Intelligent Director is basically having an AI-driven producer or director on the call that allows you to be able to kind of do things like, who are the most active speakers, and change the view. So literally like having a director making decisions for you. And so just it really allows me to be able to have that, because at the end of the day, today there will be between 300 and 400 million active daily users on the Zoom platform, right? That's a phenomenal figure. As those people come back into the office, you want to be able to give them that same experience as they come into the meeting room. They don't want the same panned out view as they used to have. In fact, that panned out view, we sometimes call it the bowling alley view, has been around since I joined Tamburg in the 90s. Like it's not new, and this we feel is the way it's innovating. Now, what's it supported on? So at the moment, Neat support it with the Neat bar and the Neat board. Poly supports it with the X30, 50, and 70. And D10 supports it as well. And as of the 5.93 release, we also support this on all Windows-based Zoom rooms as well, which there are over 100,000 in the marketplace today. And so if you've got, you know, if you're using Zoom rooms with a Windows device and a pan-tilt Zoom camera, then, you know, this smart gallery is available to you now. One of the things I think is really cool about the way we roll software out is that we don't roll out default on, we roll out default off. And so many of these features that you might not even know are available and you have to turn them on. That's really good from a user point of view, because there's nothing worse than coming in on a Monday morning and the user interface is different. And so you can, so Zoom does that very, very cleverly. So for instance, voice activation, as I showed you earlier, that's been around for some time and many customers don't necessarily use it or know about it. Well, as it becomes important, you can kind of roll it out without kind of changing people and not scaring people. Change is scary, people. So we are very, very excited with what this done. We have had a really overwhelmingly positive response about Smart Gallery. And we will be adding things like extra cameras. The best example of that is having a camera in that corner and a camera in that corner. Because if I start having a conversation with Mona, you're going to get a side view of my head. That feels like being at the dinner table with mum and dad and they're arguing and you're not allowed to talk. Right. So, but if I had an extra camera, that will give me a front-on view that allows me to you to feel more like a participant. Because traditionally, you, the remote participants, have always been the second-class citizens in these meetings. Well, no longer. We want to make sure that you feel, and you know, equitable. Feel that you are part democratic, part of the meeting experience. So that effectively, in a nutshell, is our tour. Normally, I kind of reserve this time for Q&A. So that if anyone sort of got anything, if I went over too quickly, anything sort of like, please feel free. We did record this and we will be sending this out. And we also have other resources online that you can see this. If you ask us, to be clear, we do not sell any of the hardware. We are a pure software company, but I know a company that does. So CDW obviously will be able to help you there as well. So I just wanted to kind of like make sure that that's clear. Mohammed, yes. So do you mean by content camera, do you mean something like a document camera, like a Wolf Vision or an Ava thing like that?
Yeah, like a whiteboard.
Yes. So whiteboard. So we support the Logitech product. Yeah, with the Scribe, we do support it. I just didn't show it today. Yep. Mm-hmm. And in fact, again, what we're seeing is the shape of meeting rooms is changing. And so we're seeing a shift where the video is moving to that wall as opposed to that wall. And then what we're starting to see is people sort of like putting the screen, adjacent to the Scribe or the whiteboard or there's something else. So we're starting to see rooms change. So that is it's a really good question.
All right. It's not looking like anything else. I had just one question, Robert. For how many individual users can show up in the view that you're in right now?
So I've got three streams, but one is the room. So that means I've got two streams. And noted, I can then subdivide. So I'm subdivided with Eric right now. I can subdivide each tile by up to 8. And so what happens is it sort of splits in three and then splits to Brady Bunch within the tile. Now, just because you can, should you? So that means what, 16 plus the room is technically what we're capable of. That. But if you think about it, that's a diminishing point because the people are getting smaller and smaller and smaller. So at the moment, I'd argue that the sweet spot for any room is about 8 people at the moment. But once we, in our next release, which is March, increase the stream from 3 to 5, we'll kind of see sort of like, we'll see that sort of increase significantly. And you're gonna see more and more and more over time. But that's a really, really good question. But again, so if I had a super, a much larger meeting, this isn't sort of the right solution. When there's a much larger meeting and there's one dominant speaker, you might want to sort of change it around. A couple of things as well while we're talking about it. It's not facial recognition, it's human recognition, and that's important. And so it's recognizing the shape of a human. So if you look at Eric and I, we have the same shape, right? Shoulders and a head. And so that's sort of essentially what it's doing. So for instance, I can wear a mask. I can wear a hat and it will still bring me into the call. It won't sort of like, so that it's very, very clever the way that it kind of does that. The next question I often get asked is, well, can I name the individual who's speaking? People ask that a lot. And I get that because at the moment, if I look across you, you're all named. Well, in order to do that, I have to use facial recognition software. And that is available. But if I do that, I then am now bordering into data parity, you know, data provision and security and privacy and so on and so forth. So that's not a path we're going to be going down because we don't want to hold your data. We don't want to be recognizing who's on the call. So it's a really interesting question because it's not what technology is capable of versus, you know, what we should be doing from a protection of our privacy and data point of view as well. But yeah, great question. Okay, well, here's my challenge to all of you. The hardware manufacturers in conjunction with CDW love to do on-site trials. And so now is the time as we trickle back to the office to do it. And so, work with CDW, work with us and get these units there, start playing with them. We want your experience. 25% of Zoom Room features come from customer feedback, which is a shockingly high number. Trust me, I'm from my Cisco days and my Tambo days, it was not that before. And so we listen. We implement and we can sort of implement quickly because of the speed of software, not hardware. So in fact, what's even crazier, I don't want to be rude, but one of the D10 products is 4 years old and yet it supports Smart Gallery. The reason why is because the software is doing the intelligent work. In fact, if you look at the specs for Smart Gallery to work on a PC in your room, the PC required has less oomph than the PC required for Zoom meetings. Well, because back in the day, we used to solve these problems by throwing deers, like big chips at it. We don't do that anymore. Now we put the intelligence and the features are in the Zoom cloud and the units that are controlling the call are essentially becoming dumber and dumber. I wasn't being rude about them. They're not dumb, they're just dumb. Okay, so if there's no other questions, we'll sort of let you go and give you some time back. Look out for the recording that will be coming from us imminently. And we thank you for your time.
Thank you very much, Robert.
Awesome. All right, guys, thank you.
All right, thanks everyone for joining.